Good afternoon, dear teachers and all the other members who have joined us for today's Minecraft training program. We are honored and delighted by the support provided by Usmania University School of Education as they have come forward with us at Chat India and teacher to support us in this Minecraft training program. This is a 3-day program starting from today and it will conclude on 13th of May. So I welcome you all for this Minecraft training program. We'll start in another 2 minutes. We are waiting for some more participants to join in and at sharp 3, we'll start the training session. Before we start, a quick round of ground rules for you all. Please keep your mic on mute and video on off. We request everyone to keep their mics on mute and videos on off. Participants will be muted during the session. We request you to type in your queries, questions in the chat box, and we'll be taking them at the end of the session. We request you to please type in your queries and questions in the chat box. And we assure you that at the end of the session, we'll take up all your queries and doubts. And as you all know, we are under lockdown, so technical glitches can come to anybody. So please stay calm. We all are here to learn from each other. So stay calm. Thank you. So it's 3 again. So I welcome you all to this Minecraft training program in association with Usmania University School of Education and EdChat India and Teacher. So Teacher is a professional network for educators where you can connect with fellow educators, exchange ideas, resources. We are very thankful to you all in supporting us, and your support has encouraged us to bring this training program. You can attend a lot of professional developmental activities and you can find a lot of job and other opportunities. We are working on a database and soon on the website, you'll find some lucrative work from home opportunities. So today's session is all about Minecraft. So what exactly is Minecraft? Minecraft is a popular game which is used for both fun and educational purpose. It encourages the kids to read. It enhances the 4 C's, creativity, critical thinking, collaboration, and communication. It helps in building problem-solving abilities and coding skills. It also helps develop 3D model skill, which is a basic skill for software and designing professions. We are glad to have Ms. Monica Joshi and Namya Joshi. They are the mother-daughter duo who are gamification experts as the course facilitators for us. Those who have attended Monica ma'am's session, they know that she is an IT head working in Satpal Mittal School, Ludhiana. She is a global Minecraft mentor. She has a lot of expertise in gamification. And apart from it, her expertise includes database administration, computer programming, network security, project management, etc. She has presented her projects on platforms like E2, Microsoft Education Exchange, and Hashtag Talk at EduTech Asia, both held in Singapore. She has delivered a talk in Finland over education in the use of gamification. She has won many national and international awards like Adobe Creative Ambassador, India's Top Wiz Google Teacher by Wiz Juniors, to name a few. We are glad and honored by her presence. Along with this, we have Namya Joshi. She is a 13 years of age student studying at Seth Paul Mitchell School, Ludhiana. She is a Minecraft Wiz. She is a winner of the UNESCO Club's Worldwide Youth Multimedia Competition for creating a virtual library of books mapped to UN Sustainable Development Goals. She has conducted multiple Skype sessions with many countries for teachers and students alike on the use of Minecraft in their classes. She is a budding poet, yoga practitioner, and a voracious reader. We welcome Monica ma'am and Namya on our board for this training platform. We also extend a hearty thanks to Osmania University School of Education for supporting us in this endeavor. Over to Namya and Monica ma'am. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. This is Monica Joshi. Thank you, Kaushal, for introducing us, me and Namya. And without taking a further ado, I will be passing the control to Namya. And thank you, Kaushal and Varun, for arranging such a beautiful forum where Namya is able to share her learnings with the others so that it can further transfer to the other teachers and students also. Thank you so much. And I believe that all these 3 days will be enriching learning for all of us together.
Hello everyone, I am Namya Joshi and I study in grade 8 in Seth Paul Mitchell School, Ludhiana in Punjab. And today I'm going to tell you that how you can use Minecraft in your classrooms. So first of all, let me tell you that what is Minecraft. According to me, it's an education game that you can use in your classrooms for depicting or showing some lessons which are kind of tough to learn by the students. And I am doing Minecraft for around 2 years, and I have created many worlds in Minecraft upon various other subjects. So like, I started Minecraft when I was maybe in sixth, and it was like I just got a laptop from my mother and I had to create some project, and I just saw something called Minecraft in it, and I opened it and explored all the stuff in it, and then I understood how it can be taken to a higher level. And then I started creating some lessons of the subjects. Like, I used to find maybe chemistry a bit tough before, which I don't now, because I created some lessons of chemistry in Minecraft. And then it was a self-evaluation for me that first of all I learned it and then I created something in it. So that's all about what is Minecraft, and now we're gonna start it. Let me just share my screen. So first of all, I'm gonna ask you that out of you, that who all are like ready to learn Minecraft right now? So that's really good that you all are ready to learn Minecraft. So let us start. I'm just sharing my screen. Please tell me if you're able to see my screen. Okay, so I'll just start it. First of all, let me show you about what is Minecraft.
Excuse me, Kaushal, that it is not audible. Kaushal, hello?
Yeah, ma'am, we'll just take care.
Excuse me, was I audible to you all?
No, Namya, you weren't audible. Would request you to please start again. Yeah.
So I was talking about that today. I'm gonna tell you what is Minecraft. So first of all, like I just showed you a video about what is Minecraft. It did not have any like audio in it. So yeah, it just shows that you can create anything that you want in Minecraft. So first of all, let me tell you how you can, like, why you should use Minecraft, like how to get to know about Minecraft. So it helps you in the student engagement and collaboration, creative exploration, and it also helps you to give some student-centered outcomes. So for student engagement, it can By using Minecraft as a platform for learning, you can inspire the student to learn anything that they want to learn. By collaborating, they can know that how they can work in a team. If you don't work in a team, like, you cannot understand how to work properly. And then it also helps you to increase your power of thinking and creativity. It also gives you learn-centered outcomes, that by learning Minecraft, it teaches the students some independence and perseverance, so that it gives them some great satisfaction about what they're doing. And now let me tell you some features of the education edition. So it gives you some access and personalization. It helps you to set up your world that you're creating in Minecraft. It helps you to give some learning to the students. Like I told you in the beginning that I found it a bit tough learning some subjects. And then if you create that same thing in Minecraft, it can be easier to learn. And it also helps you just to demonstrate student learning. So even the teachers can create it in Minecraft, and then you can demonstrate that using the student learning. So do you want to give it a try? Let's start now. First of all, for getting signed up, you have to go on education.minecraft.net. So I'm going to come here, and then you have to click upon download, and then download. And when it's opened, you can download it now for Windows 10 or some store version if you have. And if you have maybe iPad or Mac, you can download it for that also. And after that, when you have downloaded it, you must click upon the right click. You must right click it and have the admin rights to your computer so that you can download Minecraft Education Edition. Otherwise, there might be some glitches that might occur. So first of all, when you open Minecraft, you need to get your Office 365 accounts to log in inside, and you can put your email and password. So it'll come like, first of all, you have to sign in the email. Maybe it can be someone@example.com, and then you can add your password to it. And then you also have various skin options which you can choose, and I'm going to show you right now. And you can also collaborate using the classroom mode, which also we're going to learn. And then you have certain more things, lot of inventory, non-play characters. So to understand it in a better way, let us hop on to Minecraft. So this is where, when you open the skin options, you can choose which skin do you want in Minecraft. Like I've chosen this one from the story mode pack. You can choose any from here. And then if you have maybe two accounts, you can click upon switch accounts to go to your another account if your one of the account is not working. And then you even have the settings in Minecraft. So you can check the controls or some general settings about your video profile, audio setting about music, sound volume, and even have the language in which you can choose whichever language that you want. And if you like forget something about how to play, you can come here, click upon how to play, and you have lots of information about that over here. So now let's start clicking upon play. So it gives you five options when you open it. First is view my worlds. It shows you the worlds that you have already created. And then you have view library, in which you have some lessons that are already been created, like about coding, maths, science, art, history, language, arts. You also have some monthly build challenges, You can upload it there and they can give you some marks for that. And you also have some biomes or featured worlds here. And you can even go to how to play from here to see some additional tutorials like chemistry, code builder. And then you have this plus option for creating a new world. And this is the join world option that is for multiplayer. So when you click upon this, the friend which has hosted the world will give you a 4-digit code. Maybe it can be, maybe this. And then you have to click upon confirm. And if you have some of the worlds in your file explorer, you can click upon import. So let us start by creating a new world. You can also create a new template. It'll take you to the library, but we're starting by creating a new world. You can name your world. So I'm gonna name it maybe save the world. Any random name you can give. And then you have the default game mode, which has two options, that is survival and creative. So in a survival mode, you can like go around and search for things, break and take whatever you want to take. But if you're in a creative mode, you already have all the stuff ready with you and you don't need to like go around and find the stuff. Then we have the difficulty level, that is peaceful, easy, normal and hard. Peaceful is the one in which you don't have any zombies and all, but in easy, normal, hard you have it. Unless and until you are in a creative mode, easy, normal, hard is nothing for you. But if you are in a survival mode, I'll prefer that you can use maybe normal, easy, peaceful, because hard would be too tough and then there might be some fight with the zombies. So I'm gonna take peaceful. So this one is like when you're hosting your world so that your friends can join using the code that I told you earlier. There are different kind of codes, always different. So it's the mission levels for the people that you visitor, that he cannot break anything that in your world. Member, he can move around, break something. An operator, that means can give, and if it is like a student is hosting a world, for the teacher to come inside, so it is like compulsory that you can make it operator so that the teacher can check that whatever the student has created. Maybe it can be used for evaluation also, that you want to see that how much the child has learned and you're not able to, like he's not able to send the world to you, then you can come inside that world and check what he's created. And then we have three types of world, that are flat, infinite and whole. So the flat world is in which you only have blocks of grass, nothing else. Infinite world, if you can see this kind of picture over here, this is how an infinite world looks like. It has plains, forests, deserts, and many other things. And the third kind of world, old. In old, it is also similar way of this one only, but in that you have a specific space, and beyond that space, you cannot move. So we're going to start with the flat world. And then you have seed, it's like the coordinates, XYZ coordinates, wherever you want to spawn. And then simulation distance means if you move fast, how many chunks, that means how many chunks of grass blocks it should cover. And then if you want to show the coordinates, which are your XYZ coordinates, you can click upon this. If you die by mistake in the survival mode, you can click up immediate respawn. And then active cheats are the slash commands. In code builder, true. And if you want it to be always day, you can also make that true. If you want it to be day and night, you can make it false. And then you also have some classroom settings, that if you want it to be a perfect weather, you can make it true. If you want the, if you want to allow the mobs, that means the animals and other zombies and all to come around, you can click that. If you don't want it, you can even do that. And then we have the destructive items like TNT and all. If you want to maybe like, Okay, so till here, is it clear to you all, or shall I start again?
Hello.
I'm gonna start again with the game settings, because like this one, I hope that might be clear. So when you click upon create new, you can create a new world. And really sorry that I went a bit faster. So first thing is the world name. That means you can name the world whatever you want. So maybe I named it, so I'm gonna name it maybe save water this time. Then you have the default game mode, in which you have two options, that is survival and creative. So survival means that you have to go around and search for all the things, but in a creative mode you already have everything to do in the inventory. Then we have the difficulty level, that is peaceful, easy, normal and hard. In a peaceful mode you won't face the zombies, but in the rest three mode you might face them. So I think this one we can do tomorrow, because I had planned multiplayer tomorrow, so I can tell this to you tomorrow. And then you have three types of world, that is flat, infinite and old. So the flat world is that has only blocks of grass in it. The infinite world is it's over you have here. It has mountains, plains and other things that you have in our world. And old is also the similar way like this one, but it has a specific space in it. If you want to show the XYZ coordinates of your place, you can allow it. If you die by mistake, you can click upon upon that also. And then we have the cheats, that you want to active the cheats, that slash commands, you can allow it. You can allow the code builder. If you want it to be always day, you can click upon true. If you want it to be day and night again and again, you can make it false. And then we have the classroom settings. Perfect weather means that it'll only be sunny. There'll be no rain, thunder or snow. Allow mobs are the animals and zombies. If you want to allow them, allow. If you don't want to allow them, you might not allow. So are the game settings clear to all of you, or shall I repeat again? Okay, so now we have to click upon play. And then we can read these. These are some hacks that you can use while you're doing something in Minecraft.
We are on the screen.
It's just loading. So by the time it's loading, let me see if anybody has any questions.
you are fired. So now our world has been opened. Let me tell you that how you can, like, first of all, move in your world. So first of all, if you want to move forward, you have to press W, that is on your keyboard. And then if you have to move left, you have to press A. Then when you have to move backward, you have to press S. And then to move right, we'll press D. So W for forward, A left, S back, D right. And if you want to fly in the air, you have to double tap on the space bar. And if you want to come back, you can again double tap on the space bar. Else, you can use shift. So is this clear? Now, as you can see these small square boxes, if I'm scrolling on the mouse with the cursor, these are called the hotbar slots, through which in the inventory you can grab some things and place it here. And you have only 9 hotbar slots in it. That means, excuse me, you can place 9 things at one time. So if you press E, that is for your inventory, to open the inventory, you can grab only 9 things at once and then place it here. So is it clear? Now, we're going to start by first of all placing and destroying. So if you can see this black wavy line that is appearing on the screen, it's where you have to place a block or destroy it. So if you go on the inventory, that's by pressing E. So you have to left click on the thing you want and bring it on the hotbar slots. And again left click and place it. So at one time you can only have 64 blocks. So and they won't be finished because you are in a creative mode. So to place a block, you have to right click on the mouse. And if you want to destroy the block, you have to left click upon the mouse. So right for placing and left for destroying. So may I continue further if this is clear? Okay, so let me continue. Now, like we've placed a block, let me tell that how you can create a small house. I'm gonna create a survival starter house, maybe that will be 6x6 blocks. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 6, 6 blocks on each side. So I'm going to move forward and place one like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we can turn towards the other side and place 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, or that'll become a bit smaller, so we can increase it to 8, and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3, 4, and then we can connect it like this. Now we can, first of all, we place the blocks like this. Now we can assume that this oak wood block is the grass, and we have to place another block on it. So it looks like this. So we can place some more layers, and if you want to place faster, just double tap on the direction you're moving on. So moving backwards, so I'm double tapping on S, and automatically I'll be able to place faster. Now there are three layers, we can place two more. Roof. So what we have to do is have to place a block in front of these layers. I'll repeat again. It's like you're placing a block like this. You just have to go in there and place it here. And you don't need to worry that it won't fall, because it is not a sand block or gravel or concrete powder.
Namya, please repeat the main steps once again, right from beginning if possible.
Move forward, you have to press W, and to move left, you have to press A. To move back, you have to press S. To move right, you have to press T. To fly, you have to double tap on the space bar. To come back, and double tap on the space bar, else use shift. So is it clear, ma'am?
No, if you could repeat right from beginning.
Ma'am, I repeated right now.
Ma'am, we are recording the session, and once the session gets over, we'll share the recording with you. Namya, you can proceed. Thank you.
Okay, sir. And now, as we have created this house, we need to add an entrance for the door. So we'll count 1, 2, 3, 4. So I think 4 will be okay. And we can remove the block by left clicking. and we can place a door here. You have another, maybe other types of door also here. You can choose any. And for placing a door, you have to right click again. And to open a door, you have to again right click on the door to open it. Now, as you can see that the house is too dark, we can take some glowstones. And then we can place it on the corners of this house, bring some light. And if you want to make a place where you can sit, we can take some stairs and then you can place the stairs like this. So it will look like it's kind of sofa where you're sitting. And then you also have beds in Minecraft, so you can take any color bed from the inventory and by right clicking you can place it. And if you want to decorate the sides of your bed, you can take a lap table. It looks like it's a small cupboard, as it looks like this. And then we can place some things above, maybe slab. Cover the bed like this. And then we have some main things in our house. That is a crafting table. Chest. A barrel, and a furnace. So a crafting table is used for crafts, to craft something. And then you have chests. By right clicking the chest, you can open it and you can place it like just grabbing from the inventory and placing it in your chest. Barrel is also the same way only. And then you can even place some furnace that is used for cooking. So is it clear that how you can create a small house? Clear to you all? Shall I proceed further? So I think that's a yes. And now you can also create a roof at the top. So for that, you can take some stairs along with, I'm taking a glass. You can take any other block. So as it is 8 blocks in length, so we're gonna count till the fourth block, 1, 2, 3, 4, and just for checking that we know where's the center point, we're gonna place it like this, and after that we're gonna remove it also. So we'll place these stairs in this way, and then here also like this. And like now, the stairs have to ascend by one block. So we have to place a block. I'm taking a glass block. And you can even change it if you want. By destroying it. And again, we're gonna place the blocks. Remember that when you have to ascend, the previous stair and the block should be at same level. and then we'll place it here. And now this will be the last one, so we'll remove this as it was just for checking that where we have to turn towards the right side or left side. Now we go to the other side. Again, we place the stairs. And then place some open planks. And so it doesn't look like that it's not a real one. So we can extend it like this also. It gives it a bit suburban look. And then we place some more stairs here. So that's how you can create one house and then end it a bit backward also if you want to do that. So it's just like your width and how you want to take it. I've just ended on the front side and then you can take it toward the back and extend it from there. So now let me just tell you about the inventory. So first of all, let me tell you how you can plant some saplings. So first of all, I'm taking a sapling and then if you want to make it grow instantly, you can take bone meal. And you just need to remember that you can't place two saplings together, otherwise none of them will grow. You can leave a gap of maybe two blocks and place a sapling. So I'm just placing it randomly right now. We'll place the bone meal. So as you can see, it grew instantly into a tree. So I hope you're clear that how you can use it. You can also grow some greenery around using the bone meal. You grow some grass and some flowers. So is it clear? So now let us continue about what all we can create. So I'm going to tell about the inventory. So I hope you might be clear by now about the blocks. So you also have some cobblestone walls, oak fences, and then the fence gates. I've also explained you the stairs, the doors, and the trapdoors are just like a half door. So it's like as a door opens like this, trapdoor also like this. So like I've used the glowstone here, I can use it to decorate it or maybe cover it. So it looks like it has been hung over there and it's not like just a block. You can also use that for making some underground entrances like this. They enter from here. I can make a journal around and then place some stuff. And then how to use the cobblestone ball. You can use that for making a boundary around your house or for placing something, maybe placing this only, or some flowers or the sapling itself. The oak fence is also like that. And if you want to enter inside the oak fence, you have to place an oak fence or any other fence gate. That's the 1/4 of your like door. Then we have the iron bars. They are just like the fences that if you want to make something like a balcony here, you can do that. Then we have the glass and the glass panes. They can be used for making windows. So maybe I want to see around, I can place some glass panes. So I always prefer glass panes because they are easier to, like, they're not easier, but both are equal. But the glass panes look more presentable than the glass because the glass looks like an entire block. And this gives it a bit real effect. And then we have ladder. So with the ladder, you can climb. You can place a ladder like this if you want to climb to the roof. Climb it like this. And then if you don't want it, you can remove it. Then we have the slabs. They are just like half a blocks. So maybe I take a slab and I'll just show you that this is a block and it'll be half of the block. But you need to remember that you cannot place anything above a slab. It'll be like floating in the air. So you first need to make it a block and only then you can place. And the scaffolding can also be used for a secret base. Maybe I'm gonna make something here. I place it like this. Now, I can also make a drainage effect, like the drainage system. So for that, you need to make a water bucket. And then we'll place it here by right-clicking. So it looks like if someone sees it by near, it looks like it is a drainage effect. But who knows that when you go inside, you have treasures of diamonds here. Let's come on the next thing. And you have many other colored blocks like iron, emerald, and many other colors. And then we have these seeds and all. You also have some flowers, so you can take those and place it around the house by right clicking again. Then we have to spawn eggs. So they are used for spawning the animals or the mobs, which I should say. As you can see that you have some horses around. So if I want to spawn a chicken, I can take a spawn chicken egg and spawn it. And there are various other things which you can spawn, like a cow, sheep, pig, wolf, polar bear, cats. And then we have the NPC. So that is the non-player character. And if you place it, it looks like this. And when you right click upon it, you can give it a name. Maybe I'm gonna name it this. And you can edit a dialogue. And that's me saying that, hello, everyone. So I'm going to tell you about the advanced settings also, but that'll be a bit higher, so we can go to that one by one. And then you have these helmets, chest plates, boots, and these are just used for if you're in a survival mode and if you want to go hunting or put themselves for your safety. You have shields, arrows, bows, and then we have the potions. So to drink a potion, you just have to, I'm taking a water bottle right now, and just right click somewhere and you'll be drinking it. So let me tell you the kind of potions that you have. The first potion is potion of night vision. So if you can't see something at night, you can take the night vision potion and you'll be able to see around. Then we have the invisibility potion, and it also has a certain time limit, like 3 minutes, 8 minutes. Leaping will increase your speed. Fire resistance, if there'll be some fire around, you'll be safe from it. Swiftness will also increase the speed. Slowness will decrease the speed. Water breathing, if you're in a survival mode, then you require it. Otherwise, you can automatically breathe in water when you're in a creative mode. And certain other potions which you have. Then we have the beds, crafting tables for crafting, and chests for your storage. Then we have the signs, slate, poster, and board. So a sign is like this, and you can write anything upon it. So it'll look like this. A slate looks like this. You can write anything in it. Then a poster is like this, and a board is like this. So if I want to explain it in one word, it is 1/6 part of the board, and this is almost 2 blocks than the rest 6 blocks which you have in the board. Now let's come on the next thing. You also have some elements over here, so I'm going to tell you that tomorrow how you can use these. And some enchanted books that are used for only survival mode, not in this. And then you have a boat if you're in a water, you don't want to go like that, you can use it. There are TNTs also there that's used for blasting something around. You can use flint and steel for activating it. You can also use flint and steel for putting fire. Go a bit around. You place the TNT and you put flint and steel upon it, it will be bursted.
Please tell them how to add boards and NPC, because we have to give them a project.
I have already told. So that's all for today, that what we've learned. I hope you all are clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask that. And I'm just handing it over to Miss Monica Joshi. Thank you, everyone.
Hello. Hello, am I audible? Hello.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
All right. So I would just go by the queries that are in the chat window so that I'm able to answer the queries what you people have asked.
Dear teachers, till the time ma'am is going by the chat window to find out any queries, I'm sharing a short assignment. It's a very short assignment. Would request you to do the assignment and submit it to us.
Okay, Kaushal, if you can help me out with the queries, because there are too many messages. If you can help me out with certain queries, if you can read out, and I'll be answering besides.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay, first and foremost thing, I just saw one that how we can use Minecraft in the education, right? That was one of the question. So it is basically like I, when I took the webinar that day, I explained it that the visual aspects help the children to retain the topic or retain the explain concept for a longer time. So Minecraft actually helps in enhancing the creativity and critical thinking of the child. And as before beginning the session only, Namya explained you that she found in chemistry very tough. And then she built the same chapter here in Minecraft. And while building, her concepts got clear. So it is just like the child is revisiting the chapter and is making the concepts in their own way. So those concepts get clearer easily. So that's how, that's why I think you should use Minecraft. And the 3D effects in this application helps to explain the concepts more in a better way. I think if Varun has shared the tutorials, the lessons links in after the last session, so you can view that there were so many chapters which have been prepared, like on Egyptian civilization, then on chemistry, then on English, maths. So it can be used as per your subject, your topic, what you want the students to make that, and you want the children to build it in Minecraft. That's what I can say.
Ma'am, there's another question that yeah. How to select the blocks and how to change the colors of the block.
Ma'am, there's a question, how to select the blocks and how to change the color of the blocks. How to select the blocks and how to change the color of the blocks.
So first of all, you have to go to the inventory and then you can select the block, and there are various other colors of the block. You can, you cannot change the color. You can take another color of the block.
So
clear that you can go to the inventory and then you can't change the color of the blocks. There are different color blocks. You can choose any color by scrolling it with the mouse or just moving around with the left and right arrow keys. And then you can select the colored block and then you can choose that. And for downloading Minecraft, I'm just pasting the link in the chat window. So that you can do that, you can download it. Just a second. Okay, I've just pasted the link from where you can download the Minecraft, and it is free. Okay, next is how to select the blocks. I answered just want to know up to which grade it is applicable. It is applicable till higher grades also. You can use this with grade 12 with the programming concepts. If somebody is taking computer sciences, you can combine it with coding classes also. And you can teach even computer applications with Minecraft. So if you go and search around on the website called EdSearch, there are a few students, those who have created the replica of their own school in Minecraft. So I would say it is
well apt for your architecture designing also, and your art designing also. So you can scale it to all the levels. And also there had been a case of what you say, that learning disability in our school. So we have taken the evaluation, the test of that student in Minecraft. We have not used any other application. We gave the questionnaire in Minecraft and the child answered it in Minecraft. You have boards and NPCs, just now Namya explained you. So on the boards, you can write down the question, or there is a book, you can type the questions there and keep it. The child can come and read the question, solve and answer it and keep it there. So it is a kind of a fun game where the child is coming, giving the test also, and then child is not worried about that, okay, I'm being marked for that. Then, what is that? Made a hole and fell through. How do I get out? I have got a gray screen and blue at times. What does that mean?
Double tap on the space.
Okay, double tap on the space bar. Fly. So you will come back and double tap on the space bar, you will fly. So you have actually pressed the space bar and you were high in the sky. That is a blue screen. So double tap on the space bar once again, you will come down on the ground. So can you take a topic in math and explain how it will be useful in Minecraft? So I request you to go on this channel and look out on the various example that have been put, because if I'll be taking the topics and teaching around, then it will be actually taking a long course. We have 3 days with us. I would really love to touch with that. So I have typed the name of the channel where you can go and look for the various lessons. And then I will be sharing a website also where you can find out various different lessons towards the end of this session. Okay, any other question? Which key is pressed for inventory? It is E. E is pressed to for the inventory. And to go right, which key we have to use? D. D is used. Okay, I'm just typing all the alphabets. A for?
Left.
D for? Right. S for? Back. And W for? Forward. Okay. And double space bar. Double tap on space bar. Fly, and then same way to come back. Okay. Okay. How does it matter if people are asking answer? We are not testing you and we are not marking you. You are all teachers. It is just a test of what you have learned. You're all teachers after all. So, okay, why not let children play with Lego instead, so there's less of screen time? You can. It's not that you have to let children play with this only, but with Lego, you can't prepare your lesson, running lessons with the help of the evaluation and then adding the techniques, adding the dialogues. Lego, with Lego, you can't add the dialogues, you can't add the story with that. You're most welcome. You can choose Lego also for that. This is a play platform where you can narrate the story to the children. And in any ways, if we are looking around the era which we are living in right now, the screen time is automatically there. So we have to adapt with the changing times. Okay, Kaushal, any other queries?
One second, ma'am. Dear participants, I would request you to submit the assignment or the assessment that we have shared in the chat box, as it would help us and it will help you also receive your certificate. And for today, we would request you all to take either Hidden House or a comic book and create it on the Minecraft, so that you have hands-on for yourself also. And tomorrow when you rejoin the training program, you have a more clarity over the course and more clarity over the platform. So please submit the assessment and the assignment. We would love to see your projects, and it will also help you go deep into the details of the Minecraft platform. As of now, ma'am, there are no more queries.
Right.
Varun? And once you have filled in the assessment, please fill in the feedback form also. It will help us provide you more information.
Yes. So teachers, if you fill the feedback form, we'll be able to send you the link for today's session. And the assessment is basically taken so that, you know, we ensure your name and everything is ready for the certification. And the other set of tasks that Kaushal has mentioned, I'm just typing it down here. So what you can work over, and just like Namya had mentioned, Hidden House and comic book. So I hope you come up with these tomorrow. If you fill the feedback form, I would be able to send you the today's link so that you can go through the entire session again and start working on comic house.
I just found somebody has asked NPCs and non-player character, which is added into Minecraft to narrate a story and add dialogues. That is an NPC. And where to find tools and description? It is an inventory that is that comes with the help of E. And I am sure, Varun, you will be sharing the recording with them.
Yes, ma'am. I would be able to share the recording. Oh, yeah. If they fill the feedback.
Yeah. So with that, I'll take a leave and Namya will take a leave.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Namya. It's wonderful that, you know, you have spent your time and taught all of the teachers today. So looking forward to the session tomorrow. I hope teachers will be able to, you know, implement everything that Namya has taught today.
Thank you
so much, Namya. Thank you, Monica, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
So can you see the assignment on the main, please? Because I'm not able to see on the chat box.
Okay, ma'am. We'll just send it again. Thank you, Namya. Thank you, Monica, ma'am, for today's session. And thank you all the participants who joined us. I'll be sharing all the three things, assessment, feedback form, and assignment on the chat box. And would request you all to submit the assignment and assessments so that you can dive deeper into the Minecraft platform and bring changes into your students' classroom, online classroom, I would suggest.
Okay, great. All right, teachers, thank you.
Hello, Varun, would you be sharing the link for the feedback? I could not find it on the chat box.
Yes, ma'am, I just shared it. I'm sharing it again.
Okay, and the assessment?
All the things. So I'm sharing the link of the assessment, feedback, and the project that needs to be worked on today.
Okay, sure, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Ma'am, the assignment, I got a query about the assignment submission. You keep it safe with you, and if you have any doubts over the assignment, you can come tomorrow and get those doubts clear. And Varun, I would request you to share your email
voice
ID.
Is so breaking, that... sorry.
Varun, I would request you to share the email ID so that participants can submit their assignments here.
All right, sure. I would be able to.
ऐसे निकले ऑप्शन से